lot of what I do is telling a story. It started just being around food a lot and being really passionate about what tastes good and what looks good and what's unusual. So a lot of the things we do here are really colorful. Us needing images that were good for marketing and to really translate what we do and what we needed and how we're different. Raw meat is, I would say, for sure one of the hardest. Not only do you not want to touch it, you don't necessarily want to see it raw. Butter is sometimes hard to work with. Any kind of soft cheese can be difficult. There are definitely workarounds. One thing that can be really appealing is to kind of tell the story of a dish hot off of the pan. One tip is to take a paper towel, dip it in water and put it in the microwave and then set it behind whatever you're propping. And that can kind of give the effect of steam billowing out of it. I have a lot of tools that I like to use that are really fun and things that are eye-catching and again, kind of tell a story. You can make or break your photo. You have to make sure that you yourself have all of the proper tools you need to do this. That can be being adventurous with something or experimenting with ingredients that are hard. Ginger is one of those things that's so ugly but beautiful at the same time, and certain kinds of peppers are that way. Really finding those ingredients that kind of evoke a certain memory for you or a certain feeling when you style them can easily translate into other similar ingredients. My favorite app is called VSCOCAM. It has really interesting filters. It has different frames where you can kind of decide what you're shooting, if you're shooting horizontally or vertically. It's really helpful. Also, just look on Instagram. There are so many inspiring people doing this, and it's really fun to see the way that they do things. You would hear older generations kind of say that millennials can't wait to take a picture of their food and post it, but it's also kind of getting people back in the kitchen, and it's giving you inspiration in a way that you wouldn't necessarily have without this rise of kind of farm to table and translating that through storytelling and photography. I think it would have to be a paella that my family and I made together. I studied abroad in Barcelona, so paella is always one of those dishes that will hit close to home. And my family has since tried to recreate it so many times.